The drive shaft came down. It started to shake violently. But what can you do? You are stranded on the place where there is nobody. We'll see how it goes.
After a long winter, spent mostly close to our yurt and white horse, we decided to take a journey north to Dawson City. There's just one road to Dawson, and the drive is 535 kilometers in one direction, with few stops and very little cell reception. Well, we just had our vehicle serviced. We had a safety done before we took this trip up the highway to get to Dawson City. And now it's fallen apart. Come and check it out.
I think they forgot to put the screw back on.
That's not funny. This could have been super dangerous.
Please press 1 for a claim on an insurance product.
We have one bar.
And
it keeps cutting out.
Unfortunately, our tow trucks and service vehicles don't have plans for physical distancing. So if you need a tow, we ask that you plan another way to get home. Also, please remember to keep 2 meters from our drivers and service technicians during roadside help. Thank you for helping us keep everyone safe.
I'm not sure how
welcome to DCAA.
What happened, Tammy? Well,
this nice man stopped and asked us if we needed any help and if we had water and food and...
It's just...
Somebody's phoning me. It's a dark navy. We have our little flashing lights on. It's a straight stretch. Bye. Okay. Thankfully, he answered his phone. He was in bed.
And then he's coming?
He's coming. He was logging all day today, so he's tired.
Oh, no.
But he's going to come anyways, so I called him a hero. Oh, what an adventure. Same thing, making sure we're okay. Yeah, Northern culture is to stop and make sure everyone's okay. Because if they were stuck on the road, they definitely would want the same to happen. We all take care of each other up here. What's going on?
Just starting to edit for the next episode for our YouTube channel. And we were going to do this in Dawson tonight.
Yeah.
Since we are stranded, I might as well take advantage of it.
Doug's here to save the day. We're just hooking up the truck onto their tow truck, and Tenchi's inside our truck, probably wondering what is going on.
Look at Tenchi. Yeah.
Expecting this kind of adventure. As no mechanics work on the weekends, we had no choice but to explore this historic Gold Rush city on foot. Welcome to Dawson City! After a good rest at one of the only hotels in Dawson that will take dogs, our frosty morning began with a walk to the frozen Yukon River. We're on Front Street in Dawson City. The Yukon River flows right in front. And right here, it's frozen. You can see that there's an ice bridge across. People can drive over there. This would make a great ice rink. It's unbelievable that come May, the ice will be gone and a ferry will take cars and pedestrians across the river until it freezes up again in October.
Good girl, Dinky, good girl!
Good girl!
There's a car coming.
We just crossed the Yukon River from Dawson to West Dawson. Here we are on the ice bridge, and there's a truck here too.
Actually, it's pretty cold. Let's go to the downtown and get some warm breakfast.
The Jack London restaurant is open. Breakfast. Oh, we need breakfast.
Of course, we have to wear masks in the hotel. Tenshi, did you use your hand sanitizer? Did you use your paw sanitizer? We walk off our hearty breakfast by exploring the town. The Klondike Gold Rush began in 1896 and changed what was a First Nation fishing camp into a bustling city of 30,000 by 1898. Today, with a population of about 2,000 people, many restored historic buildings still line the streets, and you feel like you've stepped back in time to the days of the Klondike Gold Rush. You know, Dawson is so super unique. One thing we really love about it is it doesn't have any chain restaurants. There's no Subway or McDonald's. It's just little Dawson, no traffic light. They've got boardwalks made of wood. It's really amazing. It's really magical. You really feel like you're still in Gold Rush times. Gold was discovered in the Klondike, and they had dogs like Tenshi to help them pull their sleds. There's sleds of mail, there's sleds of gear, traveling from here to there, and everything just looks more golden here. I don't know if it's just our imagination or if it's really true. Even the sunset looks golden. People are just starting to turn their lights on down below. I can see the first star, which is pretty special in Dawson when it's this warm, because in a few months there's going to be midnight sun, just like the name of this establishment, and there's going to be so much daylight that you can't see the stars. This is like a holiday because we don't have to chop wood, we've got running water, I can even have a bath. Woo woo! We've been walking for about an hour and haven't seen a soul. Where else can you do that? No tourists in sight. No aurora seekers in sight. No mushers in sight. Just us and the ghosts.
The spell of the Yukon by Robert Service.
Our truck just started and it's ready to go.
We're so grateful the mechanic could fix our truck.
Temporarily,
yes.
At least we didn't have to pay for a towing fee. It would have been $1,000, so that would have been quite expensive. BCAA covered it, so thank God we both had it. First time to use it like this, and I shouldn't be driving more than 80 kilometers per hour. And right now I'm driving 80, so this is the maximum speed we can drive.
Traffic light. Lots of times when we go to these small towns and they don't have traffic lights and they don't have box stores and all of that, we come to Whitehorse and we're overwhelmed.
Overwhelmed by the presence of a traffic light?
Yes. Well, not just the traffic light, the traffic. The reason there's a traffic light is because there's traffic.
Oh, that's a good point.
Yeah.
You're smart.
Thanks.
Never thought of that. We made it.
Yay!
500 kilometers going 80k per hour. Took us 8 hours. But here we are back at home. Okay. Let's go to sleep.
Well, here we are. Our neighbors made a fire, so we're not so cold. Here's our little yurt. And a fire going. Oh, that's so nice. Yay!